Hey folks, this is Njobl Ulram-blr, and welcome back to another episode of Rambling Skyrim. Now, this episode, or between this and the last one, I got rid of the reasonable speed mod and put in instead the longer durations, and whatever I popped up on the screen, I think the first episode. Anyway, it deals also with speeds, but along with a lot of other things. So we'll see what it does with the sneak speed. It does a lot of other things. Not only does it get rid of, I'm just noticing it right now, gets things off of your compass that are not within sight. Like there is a giant area up there, and so you can see it on the compass, and you can see it on the rock too. So line of sight for your compass. Light from torches have a bigger radius. You ever been in a town and committed a crime and there's nobody within sight and yet the guards all know it and they come running? So it decreases the radius that they can detect that so that it's reasonable. So really, reasonable is the majority of what that mod is about. So many different fixes that it gives. It increases the length of some of the spells so that you aren't in the middle of something that a spell is affecting. I don't use many spells, and then have it die on you before you finish what you were doing. So anyway, that's what's up there. We were on our way toward Whiterun, and I kind of wanted to dive off. This is an indicator there's something in this area. So this path, yeah, we've got a cave of some kind over here. Been a long time. That fox just went scuba foxing. A long time since I have been out here. I remember there is something going on. So let's go peek here. And I got to thinking about something after last episode. We tried to find that treasure map. And there was another waterfall down near Darkwater Crossing, I think. I don't recall. We might, when we come back from Whiterun, head back to this area. Let's look around in here. Now we do have, I assume the river does this. So there could be another waterfall in here, and this eventually makes its way to Riften. So I don't remember any waterfalls in here though. I don't think there is, unless there's something cascading off of this. That other waterfall was just the right description, just the wrong direction. Probably put there on purpose to lead you to the wrong one, to see who's persistent enough to find the right one. But I'm curious, and it dropped me out of that mode again. That drives me nuts. There we go. Every time I can't hit a transition. What the? I only saw the ears. I thought that is the wildest butterfly, like dragonfly. This fox is just going crazy. Anything in the water here? No, not deep enough to stay under the water. I like to check the backs of the waterfalls when I can. There's only certain ones that will actually let you do anything. Oh, that wanted to be. Yeah, here I'm probably trapped or something. Anyway, let's get over to this side. It's where we needed to be. Nothing in there. Nothing hiding in there. Oh, that is quite the force you're pushed along with. Hello, fox. That's an underwater fox. Blood. Lots of blood. Not good. There he goes again. We are so disturbing his calm. We've got a body. Okay, a couple of bodies. We have a bandit over here. I'm kind of looking up the skirts of this guy. I'm freezing. A little concerned because I also... Did I mention that I also put in the unofficial Skyrim patch? So, in case I didn't mention that, I was going to. So I've changed a lot mod-wise, and both of those are very extensive changes to the game. Each of them have a very long list of things that they change. So a little worried that I'm going to be goofing up my game save here. really don't like dealing with mods. And I am kind of bouncing all over. Let's see what's in this bandit. Bandit had a leg of goat roast. Ooh, this one's edible. We'll take that one. Another lockpick, good. Fur armor, that's actually not bad. We're using a 27 that weighs 30 pounds. This 25 that weighs 6 pounds might be what we'll transition to when we go to sell things. We'll sell off the iron one. And an iron sword, which isn't as good as the other. So we'll grab all these for now. We got plenty of carry weight. And this guy got some gold, and that's it. I'll leave. None of these are worth enough to sell. So I'll leave his dignity there. Bandits don't get any dignity. But he does. He's the victim here. I am doing a lot of strange bouncing around. There is something kind of conflicting in the background. I may have to mess with some mods before I turn on record next episode. Nothing in here. So what... I usually start over here. So what... Nothing over there. You kind of walk into this place and get a progression. Trying to remember what it is. You find your first victim over here. Nord. Just wearing the basics. Ah, there's our hint. A troll skull. Have we got a troll cave over here? Going after a troll is kind of like going after a saber cat. You don't, if you're a low level character, you don't walk away from them. Well, let's go peek. Dark Shade Cavern. Hopefully it doesn't release my arrow on me. Keep that button held down. I'm in sneak mode and I'm ready to fire. Nothing in front of me. Okay. When you're holding the arrow, it really reduces your DPI. So you gotta let go to be able to spin around and see things better. Oh, getting myself dizzy here. Oh, that is really annoying. That's one of the fixes that I would think that they would have fixed in those mods. You step on a bone and it takes you out. I can't turn that light off now. And it's still, when you pull your bow, you walk faster. That's still in the game, even after all of those fixes. Okay. A lot of skull, skeleton parts, rib cages. More bright lights that show me off too well. I'll probably trip on that skull and die. Yeah, I'm tripping on more of them. Well. Ooh. I hear something. There he is. Yeah, it's kind of like going after the Incredible Hulk. When you're only, what, level 2? Is that where we are? Trees. So we've got a little community in here. I can get out of here fast if I have to. His back is to me. That's probably on purpose. They're just tempting you to take that shot. Because I'm sure nothing could go wrong. So trolls must be the ones that spear their victims. What if that other cave that we saw, it's got trolls in it. I see the same thing right there. Or that's just a general, right here too, general thing meant to scare you away. There's probably lots of things to loot in here. I don't think I can take them. I got 8 weak arrows with a weak bow, no shield. I think that's suicide. He has got hit points that never end. You gotta have some real armor on. Now I'm going to note to self. Come back when you're not a weakling. I want to hit that bandit cave just outside of Whiterun, the bandit hideout. to the... Is it already afternoon? Wow. Let's go across. More of these. Oh, that's a barnacle cluster. Okay. Am I going down current? Where'd that go? There we go. Slaughterfish eggs. That was odd to see in that other one when there weren't any slaughterfish. It's kind of an inconsistency I didn't expect. Now, I'm not sure if I've seen slaughterfish in Skyrim or not. I mean, they were all over Oblivion. It seems like I have come across a place or two somewhere on this map where I got bit. That's the way I came up, right? Yeah. Hello, Mr. Rabbit. You're not sure what to do. I've been in some water somewhere and got bit, but those might be memories of Oblivion. That one, they were in all the lakes, all the streams. All right, so already evening. We're gonna hit those towers on the path up there in the dark. That's probably a good thing. Anything just off to the side over here? Hey, I just noticed something. My sneak is faster. It is faster. Oh, good. So getting rid of the reasonable speed was a good idea. Yeah, I'm able to move at a good clip here now. Comfortable. Walking... uncrouched and running. What is that black thing there? That's the end of a log, isn't it? Uncrouched and running is too fast. There's so many things to see. Little things. That head sticking out of that bush right there that you don't notice until you've run all the way up to it and suddenly it's running at you, you know? And walking without crouched is just too slow. Well, it's that. Running is just too quick. Too much can happen in 3 or 4 seconds. Now, this is that tower I was talking about. I've got a bridge that goes across the water to another tower over there. There's a group of bandits. There's one of them right there. Another one usually perches right here. There's only one out there? I thought I saw a second one on the bridge. No, just the one. Let's get to where I can kind of peek in here and see what's going on. They do have a route to walk. I can't get up into there. I'm pretty sure I can't. Ooh. Sure wanted to. Got it. Right there. Now that one I know is a bandit. As a paladin character, you don't want to just go take the first shot against anyone. You want to at least make sure that, you're not taking out a civilian, a friendly. But this one I know is a bandit. I'm going to take the shot. Almost. There it is. And it hits a... Oh... Gonna say it hits a tree on the way over or something. How many kill cams have failed in Skyrim? Alright, well, we took that one out. I would, if I had more arrows, start working on what is the right height to get to take this guy from a distance. But not gonna go there this time. But let's see how deep into this I dare go. Studded is 25.6. That'd be the same as that other one we just got. So, any food in here? Use. No. Dare I knock on the door? There is another path up here. Down here. And there's somebody in there, I'm pretty sure. Do I have bow bash? I do. I'm going to give this a try. Wasn't there another... Oh, it's up there. That's what I'm thinking of. Okay, I do have to go in the door. Can I get to that other guy from here? Kind of. He is going to come running to assist. Got to be aware of that. Got a trap over here, and somebody has sprung it. Now, we've got one sneak and one archery, as far as points go. Where is he? Right there. And somebody's coming. Let's get out over here. One right there. They can't get me from above, I don't think. I don't have to get two shots out. That big red dot walking back and forth is probably walking back and forth right in there. Okay. Do it again. Four arrows. Am I going to need those four arrows between here and White Run? Somebody just heard me. So there's one, somebody right above me here. Let's go get this potion.
What was that? Must be my imagination.
Minor healing. Minor healing. A book that's not worth much. We'll take it. And maybe we'll just raid the chest at this time. Until I have more arrows. And better armor. So, sprung... trap has already been sprung, but... Oh, I've got three lockpicks by now, right? I think I do. Let's try it. I didn't see what it said. Is it... It's apprentice. Okay. So, are we on the lockpick? No, it's... Boy, this is being way too nice to me. Three in a row that are centered. Okay, got some poison. Put those on your arrows, and that helps out. Although in this case, it's only going to weaken their stamina, so that's not going to help much. Alright, we'll take all that, and let's just be thankful that we got this far. Okay. There is a body there I'd love to loot, but we got to go after somebody with a mace to do it. Who can see us? Somebody heard us walking away. Ah. I doubt I could have got the right angle. And then, what would I have done? You know, I'd have to run up there to take advantage of it. How much distance have they got, though? They can probably nail me if they see me. Probably so. He is on high alert. Love to be able to walk, look behind me, though. Okay. Because this is wolf country over here. Deer in the water. Deer over there. Let's get this guy back out. Okay. So this is definitely a destination for soon. That is one of them that I enjoy taking out. Now, four arrows left? Yeah. Let's not spend them on deer. I don't know who else is coming up. I know of one that's coming up, and possibly two others that tend to be on the road along the way, and a wolf up here. Let's go get some more pelts this way. Another fox. Let's get high enough. Detected. Only ones? Only ones. So they've got a fox down there and a fox up here. There's a giant area again. Here he comes. That was a little early. Where are you at? There you are. All right. Fox over here. More hides. And they took down a fox out there somewhere. Oh, there's a view. And I still can't find it. Huh. They went after a fox really fast around this way. Then this other fox came from over there, and they caught him here. Yeah, I can't see him. I don't think they made it all the way up to here. I'll take a peek, though. I'll go as far as this area. No. That is... What is the white there? That's just a bush. Okay. Well. Yeah, boy, the sneak is so much faster. Big difference. All right, there's usually a necromancer up there. Let's sneak up that way. Now, come back through here a couple levels higher, and you'll find saber cats and or bears in the area. You know, larger animals, larger threats. The game kind of throws them at you based on your level at the time. Wolves are thrown at you first, earliest. Almost feels too fast now. I want to sneak in here. This one best this way. Four shots. It's usually in there. Although, what time of day is it now? Almost 11. They do go to sleep now with the immersive citizen mod. Although, this is mostly nighttime stuff, on purpose. I don't see him. That's a tree trunk. If my sneak suddenly goes up, I'll know he's here. There he is. She is. Good shot. What was you? You conjured something, didn't you? They will bring to life. What is that called when they... Are you? Skeleton? Oh, great. I get to dodge arrows with my last shot. Come on, fire at me. Thank you. No. Shoot. There you are. Got him, but... Yeah. I'm out of arrows. Now, you're going to be coming down here. Where are you? Oh, if I had a shield. All right. Get me off a sneak. Oh, he ran out of time. I was just going to dive at him. This is how you play Minecraft with the skeletons coming at you. Get behind a tree, wait till he shoots, and then... Oops. And then accidentally hit the crouch. Anyway, you've got Nordic arrows that do damage of 10. And a bow that does damage of 10. I'll grab all that. You were what? Ash pile of a skeleton. Why? If I wasn't so close to Whiterun, I would skip this one. You can see it weighs 14 and it's worth 15. I mean, it's just not worth its weight in gold. But we've got plenty of space available to us. An iron shield. Okay. Let's armor up here. Shield, iron. There you are. All right, you're now going to pop up when the sword goes up. Weapons, let's queue up these guys. So longbow is doing 8 and this bow is doing 10. We'll queue up this one. And I guess temporarily we'll favorite that one. We'll make that our number 3. No other options here. Steel swords, no steel arrows. So queue, and you are my number 3 now. Okay. Feels different. Alright, so what is this thing? The ritual stone. Okay, so that would be more magic based, right? I think so. Well, let's loot this one. And we're coming up on midnight soon. I think I got her down here. Right down here. New. She landed in a bush or something? Oh, I hate when they go invisible. I shot from... I'm thinking I fell backwards and shot from about here, which means she fell over here. Where? Okay. They just blend right into the bushes. I got nothing. Unbelievable. Oh, right here. Okay. What you got? Bound sword. Robes that are worth 55. Boots that are worth less. And an iron dagger. Okay. We will do all of that and get ourselves out of here. Go down this way. And about here. What has detected me? I don't know. That was weird. Is that a person on the road? Or is it a wolf? I figured there'd be something up the road there. Whoa. You can still see me. I don't know how many times that's happened and it's turned out to be a skeever. I'm gonna go back down into known territory. Oh, that's driving me nuts. Okay. Let's go back to what we know. We came from there. Nothing's coming up from that way. We're going here. We cut through here to go up. We've not been there yet. But even then, there, a skeever. That's what it was. Aha. I'm gonna take you from a distance. Yeah, let's see if there's what kind of archery skills I've got. There's two of them. Three of them. Alright, told you I like the bow. Give me a good bow and I can play this game. Alright, you've just got a tail. You've got a tail and 6 gold. Is it rats? I'm thinking pack rats. Pack rats like shiny things. remember my parents' place. They live way up in the woods. They have pack rats. And they would find their tools taken away. I think traded for things. I think they're the ones that trade you. They'll take the shiny thing and drop something else off, a nut or something. It's kind of interesting. Pack rats will pack away anything that's shiny and pretty. Alright, let's take the high road. I'm feeling a little more hitting my stride now. Familiar territory. Decent bow. Decent enough to get by with what the game will throw at me now. Sneaking up on things that were meant to surprise me, one-shotting them. Yeah, this is getting a little more fun. This is Skyrim. Just the one, huh? Now, he rolled. He's down here. Just a pelt. I wonder how many pelts we've got now. Should have quite a few. Should be able to do something pretty decent with... That was a lot of shadow. Like a dragon going over. That was weird. The tree shadow just moved across there. Or something like that. But, what was I saying? I don't know. Distractions in this game. Alright. Alright, there's the beer place. The mead place. Hunting brew? Something like that? Honey brew? Nothing on the road out here. Okay. Just kind of reminiscing. So there's Dragon Reach. Okay. And there is a treasure chest up the... Where's the windmill? Up there somewhere. We'll find that treasure map soon. I'll go do something that I know I can find. there is a wolf or dog. That's a dog and a hunter. Don't take out the dog, this part that's attached to a hunter. It doesn't go well. You've got to discern friendlies from enemies, who's going after something. And hunters hunting dogs from wolves. What are you after? Oh, after a deer. Okay.
Where are you?
I'm a friendly. You are going after the deer in the wrong direction. Show yourself. I assume you're talking about the deer.
Guess it's all clear now.
Okay. Ah, here comes the deer. Oh, there he goes. Alright, now I'm going to be in their line of sight for quite a while, so I'll stay off a sneak. Let's go up higher. I heard her voice again.
You're ready to die today, huh?
What? Who? Oh, I went higher than I thought. That's actually a bandit area up there. Hey, Hunter, why don't you walk along with me? I could use some backup. Yep, we're doing this. That was the hunter helping me, that last bow or arrow. Okay. Thanks for the backup. I appreciate it. I'm still in sneak mode. It's so easy to tap that control button when you're too on for the shift button. Alright, I will take note to Rodolph. Fur armor, 25, hide shield, fur bracers, iron mace. Which is actually better than my sword, huh? I have a level up. We'll level up in town. Um, There's one more up there. How much room do I have left? Let's go into Whiterun full. The bandits, they attacked me first, didn't they? Yeah, they shot first. Where are you at? There you are. Oh, that was close. I've got a bad angle here. How can I get past that tree so I can see? Right there. Let's go this way. Where are you at? Where are you at? You're nearby. Where are you? I see the arrow, but I don't see the person. Oh, you want to hit me so bad. I can't get an angle from here. I don't think I can make that jump. Ugh, nope. Ouch. Where are you? Don't see you there. Oh, send another arrow my way so I can get a bead on you. That way. Gotta be careful, there's another place out here too. Let's go from here. Still spotted. You're in that area. Now that's not you right there, right? No. Where are you at? There you are. I gotcha. Let that arrow come through. I had ya. Thought you were right there. No, you're not. You moved. There you are. Yeah, shoot at me. There you go. Gotcha. Come on, send one over right into the tree. Ah, you dodged that one. Good. Down? Down. I'll take that. Thank you. White River Watch discovered. Alright. And this will be a mission later to come and clear this out. There's a cave entrance there. I don't know if they're mining or what they are. Yeah. See, the run speed is just too fast. That's why I go to sneak. So I'm still not convinced that I like this. Still want a run that is, well, run that is slower would just get me in trouble too. Anyways, take all of this and put this away. No one else is going to come after me. Let's loot all this stuff and call her done. Empty. You've got apples, sure. That wasn't the E. All right, up in here, that just sends you inside. Grab all the fish. Can I tan on that? No. Cabbage, never take the flower. It's worth zero by the time you get it back there. Garlic, I'll take you, and leeks. What's in there? That is a wooden spoon. Yeah. Take that. Got a chest. We've got... That's about it. Okay. Unlock chest. No traps. Alright, now don't tell me it's at the top again. Good. We finally have a little bit of a challenge. There's some movement. Got it. Alright, orc alcheming it. Amulet of Dibella increases speech skill. Ooh, that's good for when we go to sell. And steel dagger. Take all of those. Are we done here? Nothing in there. Okay. I think I do have one salt. Yeah, as far as being able to cook. I'll do that. In case you guys, some of you are new to this game and haven't seen this before. You're able to take all the food that you have available to you. But everything takes salt. No, I take that back. Not everything takes salt. Well, okay, just about everything. There's mud crab legs and butter. Otherwise, salt pile, that's what's great out there at the bottom. Vegetable soup. Takes a cabbage, a potato, a leek, and a tomato. And it will restore one health per second for 720 seconds. Ouch, what is that? 12 minutes? Something like that. And restores 1 point of stamina as well. Let's make that one. Okay. Had enough tomatoes to make one. Okay. So we can grab that before we go into a battle. And makes us healthier. So I am done here. How much room do I have left? Still got a lot. Let's grab a few of these things that are generally not worth it otherwise. Missed that one. This guy even. Nah. Okay. Grab that. Buckets, not if it, value one here is value of, you know, one quarter there. So it's got to be at least a four to give you a one over there. You lose the majority of that. We've been up top. There was nothing there but a cave entrance. Okay, let's call this one done. It's really late. Let's get into Whiterun and... Is that an arrow? That's an arrow. Iron arrow is one of theirs. They shot at me. They shot quite a few at me if I could figure out where I was at the time. But I'm thinking the sun's coming up. I was going to... 4:30 in the morning. Okay. I was going to run in and grab a room, but... I think we'll just have to skip tonight. Just looking down in here. What is that? Is that a log? I think so. So I've got a level up ahead of me. I think I'll do that in town. Or I could use it on speech. Are you alive? You are. I can't get up there. Okay, we're gonna... Ouch, ouch, ouch. I'm gonna do this. Where are you at? You ran that way. Where'd my arrow go? I'd like to get that back. Hello. Dog bark. I think Hunter took it out. There's no more red dot. Okay, I was over there. I shot, what, this thing? Yeah, I think that arrow may be a goner. What was that? That lit up. There you are. I got my arrow back. Okay. Well, enough rambling here. Let's get going. I think that hunter made it up there and took out that skeever for me. Hunters are your buddies. Probably no reason to sneak anymore. That's the way to Riverwood, if I remember the town name. Which is really confusing as a new player to find. Because this doesn't point there. Why would there not be an arrow pointing to Riverwood? And there's no other post. When I, right at the very beginning of playing Skyrim years and years ago. I wanted to get to Riverwood. I could see it on my map. But I couldn't tell what road to take because this seemed to indicate that that was not the way. That was confusing. I paced back and forth for a while before I finally figured it out. Now, heading... Hunting Brew. Not Honey Brew. Okay. Wandering into Whiterun usually has a giant being attacked by a crowd up in here. And if you don't get there in time to help out, they call you a coward for not assisting. I think I just saw... Yep, there's a big old club. Oh, he hit something too. Let's run up in here. At least we can watch it happen. Even if we don't get there in time to do anything. When he hits, he hits. And I didn't get there in time. Okay. Anyway, we'll let them do their thing. We don't need to be part of that. There's a leak. But here's Whiterun. It's a significant sized town. Very different from the other towns. Well, some of the other towns. Some of them, like... Windfall? Yeah, Windfall. Are quite dark.
Funny suit and all. Just north by the Laureus farm. Fool had a coffin in a cart with a broken wheel. I'd like to see him laugh his way out of that.
Okay. We just got a quest thrown at us.
We've had quite the journey, Ulfka. But you were gone longer than usual. I got to thinking maybe you weren't coming back.
You sound like my ma. Figured I was lying dead in a field somewhere, is that it?
Thought did cross my mind, yeah. War brewing, talk of a riot in Helgen.
Alright, we'll let them have their conversation. But that's one thing that the immersive citizen does, is it will cause them to have more conversations with each other. Or it also resurrected a lot of scripted events and conversations that had been taken out of the game, but the files were still within the core game files. Just laying there dormant. So they went through and activated all of them. Now, are you guys going to stop me and say nobody is allowed because of the dragons? You're not. So one of these mods, probably Alternate Start, did a good job of deactivating the Dragonborn scenario until you actually trigger it. I think you can override this by killing a dragon. And then it turns the main quest back on. All right, what time is it? 6 in the morning. Both of these should be open. Hello? Just you? Yeah. Are you going to be rude?
If you need potions, you should try Arcadia's Cauldron.
See, I told you this was a nice town. Go to some of the other places,
we'll
they just assume that you're a dirtbag.
I just can't fill an order that size on my own.
Kind of want to talk to her, but let's go up in here and... into the Drunken Huntsman. Now, before I go to sell this, I should swap out armor. So I'm not standing there naked. He's not here. Why is he not here? He's always here. Well, that's new. Okay. Then I guess we'll go and have a talk with her. Still got to change out that armor, though. So we are wearing the iron armor. 27 armor, 30 weight. We're going to switch out to the studded. 25 armor, 6 weight. It's almost the same. We'll upgrade it. So that'll get us at least back to the 27. So we'll do that. The other one that was available was like fur, right? Fur armor. Also 25.6. What looks better? Not that one. Yeah, we'll go with that. Okay. So anything else I need to do? I need to put on the apparel. Oh, that is apparel. What was that called? Something of Debella, I think. Necklace? And no, not necklace. What would it be? Charm? Amulet of Debella. Speech. So that should increase my ability to talk him into a better deal. So we'll put that one on. Okay. And let's go and talk to... I can't remember her name anymore. This is Adrian? Adrian?
Got some good pieces out here if you're looking to buy.
Actually,
more inside.
I am, so let's... Tell me what you got for sale today.
Blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs.
Great. What can we sell? You've got 5,000 gold. That's right, that newer mod that took the place of reasonable speed added gold to all the merchants. So you're not coming back with a big haul and having to wait for days to finally unload it all. I used to go to a barrel over on the other side of her blacksmith shop and store things that I knew she couldn't afford and come back later and try to get rid of them then. Anyway, you're not scrolling. Oh, she only accepts from these three categories, that's why. So, weapons, let's get rid of the war axe. So that was 15 and now it's worth 5. So one third is all you get. Iron arrows we'll keep, they don't weigh anything, so there are emergency backups. Get rid of the daggers. And iron mace was a damage of 10. The steel sword is a damage of 9. Let's switch out to here, I guess. So a steel mace is really what we're looking for as far as a backup. Alright, we'll do that. Steel dagger. Get rid of... I guess both of the longbows. Yeah. Alright, so the ancient Nord bow until we get a hold of an imperial bow or an orcish bow or something like that. Alright, so we're keeping those guys. Only 5 arrows left, so we're going to want to buy arrows. Apparel? Let's get rid of all of this stuff. 2 of those. Hide shield, iron shield. 22 weighs 12, 17 weighs 4. It's a big difference. We're going to keep the 22. Iron armor we're going to sell, and we're going to sell one of these. Alright, miscellaneous. We can get rid of tusks and horns and things, but it doesn't look like we have any of those. Really? Well, we probably do, and she doesn't accept them. Okay. Don't really need an orichalcum ingot, but it only weighs 1 pound. All right, we'll keep that. So, off to her stuff. Let's see. As far as upgrading, I'm going to want to do that while I'm here. I don't know what upgrades an ancient Nord bow, if it's even upgradable. So I'll wait on that one, unless it's a bone or something. I'm not sure. Iron mace. We need 1 iron. We need studded armor. Is that leather or is that iron? Probably leather. We'll make that. Iron shield, so 2 iron. Gauntlets, probably 3 iron. And then some hides. So we need to get 3 iron from her. Let's do that right now. Iron ingot. Let's grab 3 of those. It feels like my game is getting bouncy. I must be getting that 1 hour point. And starting to lag. Seems like I'm going to need some of this. I just don't know. For the buckles. For the bandolier bags. But I don't know if I need ingots or ore. So I'll wait before I buy that. Nope, didn't mean to click that. Go away. How many of those? No. Alright, weapons. What do you got in the way of arrows? Tell me you have steel. Steel arrows, 26. I will take them all. Otherwise, you've got a hunting bow at 9. Not much else that would interest me. Apparel? Probably nothing. No, nothing that I want. And that is it. We can sell more things to the other one. So we still have more potential than just the 227 here. Let's tab out of this one.
Don't forget to check inside the shop if you need anything.
All right, thank you. Wow, really bouncy. Yeah, let's do this. See what I can do right here. Yeah, before we shut the game down. So, miscellaneous will let us make leather out of. Look over below the leather. We've got wolf pelts 15, or goat hides, or fox pelts, or elk hides. So let's do all of them. Just keep clicking the yes over here, and it'll bring them all up. That gave us more smithing. Okay. Alright. And let's go ahead and make one more set of those. Okay. So, that is done. If you click on leather now, you can see the bandolier mod. Here's all the things that we can make over here. But I need buckles. So I need to forge those. Yeah, I need to figure out what it is that I need to forge them with. So let's kind of vibrate over here to this. Grindstone. Okay, ancient Nordic bow takes a steel ingot. Okay, we'll grab one of those. But let's use one of our iron ingots here for the mace. And R does that.
Not too shabby. Apprentice level work, but solid.
Well, thank you. Can I buy a steel ingot from you?
I don't claim to be the best blacksmith in.
I never said you were. Okay. Miscellaneous. Steel. I'm curious to see steel ingot good. I think there's only one that I would need. Curious to see if the game fixes itself somehow. Look now, the temperature of my my case is not any hotter than normal. I clicked. There we go. Alright.
Mm-hmm.
And let's do this one, and then we'll see if we can use her workbench. Alright, so that is going to take us to a 12. Good. And I'm trying to think what the steel, what damage the steel arrows did. I want to say 8. No, the iron arrows did 8. 12? So that gives us almost, potentially 24 per shot there. Okay, good. R. Okay, that's done. She's done, so I'll grab this. And hide boots. Let's take that up one notch to 7 armor. Iron gauntlets. Take that from 11 to 12. Not big improvements until you add them all up. Shield, 22 goes to only 23. And we don't have a lot of skills in the studded armor. Took an iron ingot. All right, let's get one more iron ingot. We don't have a lot in the way of points put into it.
Got
so.
Some good pieces out here if you're looking to buy. Take a look.
Okay. One more iron ingot, please. Great.
Don't forget to check inside the shop if you need anything.
Well, maybe at 8 o'clock. I think you're kind of misleading me right now. That door's locked. All right, you up to 28 armor. Great. So we've got a little bit past what we had before. So you're done. Now let's go see what it takes to make buckles. Oh, yeah, the lag there. Buckles, what would you be under, miscellaneous? Sort of buckles takes just steel. Okay. Let's buy all your steel ingots.
I don't claim to be the finest weapons and armor.
You're kind of repeating now. All right, miscellaneous. I'll take all of your steel, please. 5 of them. Actually, no, I won't. Okay, I'm going to have to come back here.
All right, then.
After I sell off the other stuff to buy the rest of her steel. Anyway, miscellaneous assorted buckles. So just random different buckles that we're going to use for the bandoliers. There's another smithing. All right. Keep this up, we'll be able to level up twice. But I need to walk across there and sell more stuff and then walk back over here and buy from her and do this, and it's going to be too vibratey. So we're going to call this one done here. Anyway, this has been Njobl Ulram-blr. Thank you guys for watching, and catch you next time, folks. Bye-bye.